honestly, I hope you guys enjoy my intros because those things take a lot of energy. You guys better enjoy my intros because those things take a lot of energy out of me. Yay, I'm tired. It's hot. It's hot. It's summer. And I'm doing these things on camera. In summer. In all black. Dude, I'm burning. I'm burning. And speaking about my intro, did you see my pants? Ooh, did you see my pants? Oh, let me tell you. Man, listen. I'm going to give you a moment to breathe. And breathe out. Because damn, these are fire. And if I do say so myself, these are fire. I mean, I did the things that were needed to be done. Like, I just, what did I do to these pants? I just painted a cool little dragon on them because I was bored of them and I needed to like revamp them. And I was like, even if I flopped the painting, they were 10 rand anyway, so I'm not gonna flop the painting. And I think I did a good job. And I've had this weird thing, I don't know why, I'm having this weird thing where I'm painting my old thrifted pants because I'm just tired of them. But like, I think I did a good job with these. I personally think I did a good job and I love them. I love these pants. But anyway, guys, thank you for coming back to my channel. Welcome home. Welcome back to my safe space. Welcome back to your safe space. Welcome. It's really been It's been long, hey? It's been long since I've last posted, hey? It's been long. You know what? I have no excuse for that. I genuinely don't have an excuse. Besides that, I'm very inconsistent, and I'm not going to come to this platform and lie to you, say that I'm going to work on my consistency this year. I'm really going to try to upload more and more Those lies will never escape my mouth, personally. So I'm just going to tell you the truth. We're gonna see where this goes, okay? We're honestly gonna see where this goes, but I will sort of say that I'll try to be more consistent. I will genuinely try to be more consistent. I'm gonna try to upload weekly from now on, and I'm gonna try to give you guys the content that you guys have been asking for. That is some bull. You guys have seen the title of this video, and yes, I know you guys have seen a lot of these, and yes, I'm going to do another one, but yes, I'm doing a Q&A. Listen, guys, now, from the bottom of my msunu, from the deepest trenches of my msunu, I did not want to do this video because I felt like it has been abused, but at the same time, I felt like this video was necessary because my previous videos, you guys sort of saw my personality, but I wanted like a video where you could really get to know me more on a more personal level since I am going to be more consistent-ish on YouTube. I wanted you guys to get to know me on a more personal level, which is why I took to my Instagram and asked you guys to ask me questions about me, like any question, and I said that I would answer them as truthfully as I can. And I got the questions on Instagram, and I'm going to be answering them. Thank God that none of these questions were too hectic. Thank God that they were PG. Oh, thank you. But like, the problem with these questions is a lot of them had to do, which annoyed me, guys. I want to ask a question. Before I start, I want to ask you, my audience, a question. Because, yay, enjoy that, Gabby. Why do you want to know if I'm in a relationship so badly? Why do you want to know if I'm in a relationship so badly? Like, Ms. Nginap, how is that your concern? Like, so many, like, literally everyone who asked me a question followed up a question of, are you dating? Who are you dating? Are you in a relationship? Okay. Now, let's start the first question. Okay. Not a question, but I just wanted to say you're amazing. Aww, thank you. Listen, the person who asked me this question, listen. You have been the one of the few people that have consistently asked me, where are you? Where is the content? You have been dragging me, sis. Like, throughout training, you were dragging me through the mud. Where is the content? We want the content. What was the reason? Like, consistently, you have been asking me and you've been dragging me. And like, I'm here because of you. Honestly, like, you are the last straw. Like, when you told me like, dude, we've been waiting. And like, literally, I came back here because of you. Because like, literally, like, you dragged me fulfilled, sis. You dragged me fulfilled. And I just want to say, girl, you're amazing. Just the way you are. Next question. What have you been up to lately? Any new projects? I've been modeling for a lot of my friends' businesses and brands lately. all, and it's really been fun, and I'm so glad to be helping my friends do that. And at the same time, I think they're also helping me get out of my comfort zone, because I didn't really like modeling that much. I know,
surprise.
Right, next question. Why did it take you so long to post? Yeah, again, you keep dragging me. This is the same person. This is the same person who's been dragging me. You keep dragging me. What did I do to you? What did I do? Okay, so the reason why it took me so long to post, honestly, two problems. Consistency and struggling to juggle things all at the same time. Not time management. That's not the word. Consistency and what do you call that thing where you struggle to juggle all of your things? There's a word for that in the English dictionary, but I'm not so well-versed in the English vocabulary, so... But yeah, those are my two reasons why it took me so long to post. And the same old thing of just not believing in yourself. I'm lying. No, I'm lying. It's not that. I always believed in myself. No, I'm lying. That wasn't a thing. No, that was never the thing, no. It was more of a... Yeah, it was more consistency. I really do struggle with being consistent. Like, when I start something, I started very well, but then I don't keep up the pace. And when I started on such a high pace, it's hard for me to keep up that pace. And when I stop forever and I don't carry on. And that's a habit that I want to stop doing, because I feel like it's hindered me from being where I can truly be. So I'm not going to do that anymore. So that's why it took me so long to post. What's my favorite thing to do? What is my favorite thing to do? Oh, this is so sad. I have a lot of favorite things to do. Okay, like my top favorite things to do, like around... It's like shopping, specifically thrifting, drawing. I really do love drawing. And watching series. Like, I have a weird obsession with watching series. Like, I will watch a series. I will binge a series. And you will see me there on Ending Explained, Theory Explained. You see on YouTube, after that, I watch a series, I will go on Ending Explained. I will go on literally all the theories and I'll watch all those videos. I will try to engage with anyone who's watched the video, I mean the series. But like, yeah, those are my top favorite things to do. Drawing, thrifting, and watching a good series. I'm a lazy person, so... Alright, what's the next question? Best Disney movie. Is that a joke? There's only one. There can only be one. Anyone who fights me here can go fight with their grandmother. Honestly, there's only one. Cheetah Girls. Two, to be specific. Cheetah Girls 2 is the only one. It's the only one. All you uncultured, all you lame-os, all you basic biatches who say things like Camp Rock, excuse me. High School Musical, oh. Those are the only good competitions, but nothing comes close to Cheetah Girls 2. I am sorry. First of all, the diversity, the style, the quality of the song. The lyrics, the emotion, the drama. Listen, Cheetah Girls 2, it has to be Cheetah Girls 2. Honestly, Cheetah Girls 2 gave the best bops. The best bops. I don't care who you are, don't even come for me, I say what I say. I give it to you. Yeah, Cheetah Girls 2 is the only natural and logical option for best Disney movie. Like, have y'all heard Cinderella? Have you heard It's Over? Have you heard Sprite? Have you heard Amigas? Cheetahs, friends for life. Oh yeah, do you miss high school? What are your thoughts and experiences looking back? Personally, I'm glad to be done with it, much happier now than I was then. Agreed. 1000% agree with you. I hated high school. I loved the people, well, some of them. But I hated the experience of high school because the person who asked me this question, you know our school. Oh, that school that we went to. Ugh. That little small Christian private school there in Madrid that we went to was horrible. I really didn't like that school, to be quite... You know what? No, I'm lying. It was a good school, but it didn't really give you the space to explore yourself and really be yourself. I didn't like high school. I don't know what it was about high school, or maybe I just didn't like the school I was in. But like, I liked the people from that school. And what I hate, and what's so surprising is that the people who went to that school are literally stars right now. Like, one of them is an actual star. Like, one of them is an actual famous, I'm a rapper / I'm a piano star right now. Like, the biggest, we sing songs literally all the time. That school actually produced like stars. Like, I won't lie, my high school produced stars, and it is producing stars. I mean, star in the making, hello. But like, That high school really helped everyone back. Like, literally everyone who left that school is so amazing right now. Like, y'all are stars. Y'all are stars. I do not miss high school. I do not miss that experience. It really held so many people back. I don't know if it was the people holding other people back, because it was a Christian school, so it was very judgmental. Extremely judgmental. So I don't know if that's what contributed to what was holding everyone back, but like, literally everyone, since anyone who went to that school after leaving, they're doing so amazing.
Yes.
How have you grown from the person you were in high school to the person you are now? First of all, the person I was in high school doesn't exist anymore. Listen, that person doesn't exist. We don't speak about her. We've never met her. She doesn't exist. She disappeared from the fate of the world. That person just disappeared. Listen, I've grown so much from high school. So much. Because high school, in my opinion, is very limiting. You're extremely limiting. Like, you can't really explore who you are to the fullest in high school. Like, it really limits so many facets and dimensions of yourself. And really, once you leave high school, I feel like everyone literally closed up after high school. Very few people look worse after they're in high school than they were in high school. Like, very few people. Everyone looks better. Everyone looks better when they leave high school. Everyone feels better. Everyone, I wouldn't say everyone's necessarily a better person, but like, you're a better you. And personally, I've grown so much. Confidence, number one. I became so much more confident when I left high school. I became so much more confident in my sexuality when I left high school. Even though I was already confident in my sexuality, but like, I became, like, I put like a stamp on it. I started exploring my style more, because you know, when you're in uniform all the time, you can't really explore yourself via style. And I started exploring and expressing myself via my style, which I enjoyed so much. I started becoming more social, met new people, learned a lot of lessons when it comes to people. Like, I grew so much when I left the high school environment. Like, so much. And I've also, like, seen so much as well. Like, when you leave high school and you also meet new people, different perspectives, and that's one thing that I enjoyed the most about being in high school, that I saw life from a whole lot of different perspectives. Because in high school I was really in such a small bubble, and it was really nice to have that bubble for a little bit. So I would have grown so much from that little place that I went to in high school, and I'm so proud of it.
Okay, all right, let's move on to the next question. Yo, I feel like this section is the dating section. You see, this is what I was angry about. This is the dating section. Yes. This is the section of questions where you guys like asking things about men. But it's okay, let me just answer them. Okay, child, first question is, what kind of a man are you looking for? You know, Lyonkin Tipi Yawasha, hey? Lyonkin Tipi Yawasha, Bonku Chwala, Yadawa, Uzo Dawa, Bonku Chwala, Uzo Geza, with all the soap. What am I saying? What kind of a man am I looking for? Nothing, I don't know. To be quite honest, I don't know how to answer this question. Y'all are putting me on the spot, child. Y'all are putting me on the spot. Okay, basically, I would just want anyone who could just fit with my personality, I guess. I realize that I'm attracted to I'm attracted to people's personalities. And a personality that I feel would match mine, if I were to say that. Obviously, like, to a certain degree, like, physical, but like, when it comes to physical, I don't really have preferences. I've realized that I'm attracted to whatever I'm attracted to when it comes to physically. Like, when it comes to men, I can be almost attracted to anyone. Depending. Like, yeah, it's just depending. But like, mostly what I look for in dudes is their personality and if it like fits in with mine. I like people who are extroverted, who are funny, who have like a personality, and also like people who aren't, who are strong in their sexuality, if that makes sense. Who are strong in their, yeah, people who are confident in their sexuality and people who are confident in their masculinity or femininity, like, and people who don't care about that type of stuff, like, that actually attracts me even more. Another question, why are you so hot?
I'm a hot girl, I do hot shit, finish income on my outfit.
Let's see, if you were a song, what song would you be? If I was a song, what song would I be? You know, if you asked me this question in 2017, I would have said Jill Scott, Golden, because that song was literally, if my life had a theme song, that song was literally my theme song. Like, I was literally a huge golden ball of sunshine. Like, literally, I used to listen to that song every single day. And you know what? Honestly, if I still had a theme song, I would still say Jill Scott Golden. In 2017 it would have been Jill Scott Golden. But what would it be now if I had a song? Wait, what? Yeah, if I was a song, what song would it be right now? I think probably a Kaytranada song. But what? Definitely a Kaytranada song. But what Kaytranada song would I say I am right now? I'll come back to this question. I have to think about it. And I don't have time. I'll come back to this question. What's my type? I think I already answered this question, but I don't think I have a type. Yeah, I don't have a type necessarily, but I would say someone who is A, comfortable in their sexuality, whatever their sexuality is, someone who's comfortable in their sexuality, someone who's who doesn't have a fragile masculinity, someone has a great personality, like who's extroverted. I realize that I'm attracted to people who are funny and extroverted and have a little bit of personality. Do you have a 5-year plan? If yes, what is it? A 5-year plan. Do I have a 5-year plan? Yeah, I do have a 5-year plan. Hopefully not to be poor. Does that count as a 5-year plan? Like, I'm serious. I just hope personally, I hope in 5 years, I'm not poor. How old would I be in 5 years? Let me think. How old am I now? In 5 years, I think I'll be 27? Surely I can't be poor when I'm 27. Surely. But my 5-year plan... Oh yeah, in 5 years, hopefully, I either see myself living in Cape Town... or the UK. I'm manifesting, because I really want to start all over and start somewhere like new, different. So I really see myself living either in Cape Town or in the UK. I really want to move to the UK because I feel like the UK is a country that would really suit my personality and my growth as a human being. So I would love to move to the UK because South Africa is the ghetto. It's really the ghetto. So that's where I see myself in 5 years. What's your favorite movie? My favorite movie would have to be probably anything that has to do with like the Marvel universe. Any Marvel movie. I don't have a favorite movie per se, but like anything that has to do with Marvel, I would count it as a favorite movie. Like, yeah, Marvel movies are my favorite genre of movies because I'm a sucker for a good superhero story. Especially a Marvel superhero story. And Kevin Feige and the Russo brothers over there at Marvel. Mwah. Listen, y'all are talented. Multi-talented. Because wow. Have you seen what they're doing with WandaVision? Wow. The talent. The sheer talent. The sheer creativity. The sheer genius. Genius. People, they are Marvel. So yeah, definitely anything that has to do with Marvel, I am within. Next question is, how old am I? Cue the music. I don't know about you, but I'm feeling 22. Everything will be alright if you... Briga. You know what? I would like to say that Taylor Swift lied. She lied. She said, when you turn 22, everything's gonna be alright. Ma'am, I would like to see you for lying because ever since I turned 22, nothing has been alright. Okay, and I've only been 22 for a month, so nothing has ever been alright since I turned 22. 22 is the ghetto. Oh, what a horrible age to turn. It's such an awkward age to be at, because now 21 you can get away with being a kid, but like now you're 22, you sound old, and now you have to get your life together and your shit together. And but anyway, yeah, I'm 22. My next question is, are you dating someone? No, I'm not dating someone. I'm very single. Been single for the past 22 years. Still going strong. Probably for another 20 years. Yay! When did you start thrifting? When did I start thrifting? Child? Oh, I remember when I started thrifting. I started thrifting in 2017 when I got into varsity. Oh, Lord knows that I needed to find thrifting because wow. Wait, before I say how I started thrifting. I started thrifting because do you know how expensive retail stores are? And at that time, just for my personal style at the time, the retail stores that had my personal style were Topman, Zara, H&M, Cotton On. I was never a Cotton On. Between Zara, H&M, and what was the third one? Topman. And those things were expensive, and now that I was officially living alone and I was living off a set allowance, personally, I could not afford that. Like, literally, one jacket at Zara would be my allowance. So, that didn't make sense. So, thrifting was perfect. Like, literally, as soon as I found thrifting in 2017, I was like, mwah. You see, I am piety inside, within. And and we're finished. That was my last question. The questions are finished. And if you got this far in the video, girl, you are a real one. Like, I freaking hate recording with phones. Like, yo, listen, if you got this far, let me tell you something, honey. Let me tell you a little secret. I have been trying to film this video for the past 2 days. And look, right now, I'm in my underwear. Like, for this half of the video, I'm in my underwear because this is day two of trying to film this. Like, there's somewhere in the middle of this video where it's not the same day and it's a brand new day. Being a YouTuber is a scam. That's all I would like to say. Being a YouTuber is a scam. See you in the next video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Don't forget, being a YouTuber is a major scam. So, I am going to leave because... Who is blasting gom? Who is blasting gom? And it's gom style even. Who's blasting gom style in this house? Is it my father? Is my father blasting gom style? Anyway, okay guys, I'm gonna leave. I'm gonna love you and leave you. Stay tuned for my other videos. It's been cute.